y'all, happy Vlogmas day 20. First of all, before I even start recording, I just want to go ahead and give a special birthday shout out to my little sis Lena. Happy birthday. Yeah, you say happy birthday, Auntie Lena.
Happy birthday, crybaby.
And don't call Auntie crybaby, that's daddy's special nickname. But anyway, guess what came in the mail? The Christmas cards. Well, the holiday cards. The holiday cards. So I'm getting ready to bust this bad boy open. Hurry up, throw these addresses on there and shoot them out in the mail. And pray for the best, y'all. Alright, so we just mailed out one batch. Well, I gave one batch of holiday cards to my husband to mail out, and then I realized I ran out of stamps. And you know what? I was supposed to make sure I had enough stamps before I started addressing envelopes, but y'all know I've been going through. But anyway, he went out and got us some more stamps. And look at these. Aren't these the cutest little stamps that you ever saw? Little holiday stamps. He got the last ones too, like in the store. So yeah, I got a whole nother batch of cards to send out, and then I have a few addresses that I just need to make sure are correct and get some addresses for some folks, and then we'll be back in business. So I'll probably mail out the last few cards later today, and then I have a pickup order to pick up. It's been sitting there for the past couple days, but they said they'll hold it till Christmas, so it's not like a rush for me to pick it up. And I think we've got some more items to donate. I know my husband was in a cleaning frenzy earlier today, and he was like, do you need this, do you need that, because if not, we're throwing it away, we're giving it away, we're donating it, blah 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 blah. So I was like, okay. So yeah, it's actually lunchtime, so I'm just heating up some of that leftover orange chicken and rice that I made last night. Heating that up for lunch and just enjoying this little time that I have to myself, because my husband took our son to the park, which was nice because, you know, the baby was getting restless. He was like, look, I want to go fly a kite. I need to go do something. And yeah, so hubby got him dressed and took him to the park all by himself, which is very nice because that gives me a break. So thank you so much, babe. I really do appreciate that. And I know our little one loves it too, because he loved playing around in the park with daddy. Got my leftovers. About to sit down and eat. Then maybe a little bit later, I'll actually start to get myself dressed and ready for the day.
So sad. Why is our whole team out with COVID? This stuff is serious. They just need to cancel the game. Lay, what you up to, buddy?
I got to change the camera.
Yeah, that's my boy.
And the dinosaur bones.
You eating dinosaurs?
Yes, I eat dinosaurs in chicken nuggets.
You're not eating dinosaur chicken nuggets right now. Those look like Nello wafers.
Nello wafers?
Yes. I thought those were Nello wafers.
What's Nello wafers?
They're not Nello wafers.
It's the Nello wafers.
Okay. Can I get one? Thank you. Oh, nom, 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 nom.
Nom, nom, nom.
What's mommy doing?
I love my Lincoln. It's the best that ever was. My Lincoln is the best. And I love you just because you're always a great person. You're funny and you're fun. You're great. Nathan, that apple was. It's true. I love you.
Got that all on the bleezy. Hey, y'all. So.
Really?
So, yeah, I just woke up from a nap, took a shower,
How dare you deceive me like that?
What? No, I had already turned on the camera and then you just started singing. And I was like, oh, what a precious moment. And I was just talking about how you was a great dad earlier in the vlog. So I just let the beautiful bean footage keep rolling. But anyway, I wanted to get a yogurt to go, a crumble. Yeah, so I just took a shower and I actually gave the baby a bath today. Like, it's been a while since I gave the baby a bath because that's usually daddy's duties, but I let daddy take a shower by himself, not have to worry about nothing. And I told him I would bathe the baby, so yeah, that's what I did. And now we are sitting down to get a snack. And yeah, I know I told y'all I was gonna pick up that order that I ordered a few days ago. Finally head out to go pick up that order. I'm not doing that. I don't think so. Not today. I'ma let it sit there till tomorrow. Now tomorrow I will probably, you know, head over to pick it up. But yeah, so I'm gonna eat some of my $2 hot fries. They actually went up because they used to be $2 only. Now they $2.29. Inflation. But anyway, I'm gonna eat that. And my, what is this? You like really get louder, trying to get louder than me. Like everybody want to hear you eating. And I'm gonna eat my little crumbles dessert.
Do you, wife? Do you?
All right, y'all. So it's about what time is it? It's about 8:30. So it's like bedtime around here. I am about to do some edits, looking at a little bit of YouTube, and probably getting ready to have a little nightcap and watch something with my husband. We were watching the show Grandview. I don't know if you all have heard of that show, but it's premiering. Well, the official premiere is January, the beginning of January next year or whatever on NBC. But they had like two preview episodes recently air or whatever. And so we checked it out. It's a new comedy series. And boy, was it funny. The intro was done by the legendary Garrett Morris. So I was very intrigued about it, and I like the fact that the premise of the show is they're showing the multiple layers and dimensions of like black men and like the friendship dynamics that they have, and that black men are not just one way. Like, we look at them as though like they're supposed to be tough all the way, they can't be silly, they can't be vulnerable, and you know, that sort of thing. But the show is hilarious. We enjoyed it a lot. My husband was like, it's just two episodes, where's the rest of it? And so I was explaining to him that it was kind of like a couple of teaser episodes. But yeah, if I find a little bit of the clips, I will put them in for y'all. But yeah, so we checked that out yesterday. And then we also finally got around to watching BMF. So I bit the bullet and finally got Starz back, because I had let it go after Power had ended. But I went and I paid for Starz again, so we started watching BMF. Yeah, because we have been hearing that the show, well, I have been hearing online a lot of buzz about the show, so I was trying to, you know, give it a shot and stuff. Of course, I'm very familiar with BMF. You know, Young Jeezy is my big homie, if you know what I mean. So I know all about BMF. No stranger to their story. Of course, I don't know, like, the details of, like, their early, you know, early beginnings and stuff like that. So I think it's really cool that he has his son, that Big Meech has his son playing him. And this is another 50 Cent produced show, so y'all know how that is. I think 50 kind of like knows his lane. He's doing very good with like producing television shows, you know, the shows that I've checked out anyway. But I think it's kind of interesting that he made this show, but he hasn't made a show on Supreme, which, if you know, you know, his ties to Supreme. But he made a series about BMF. But I digress. Yeah, like I said, it's been a lot of buzz about the show. You know, as I said, Lil Meech is playing Big Meech. Who else they got up in there? They got Lala Anthony. We saw Cash Doll. Matter of fact, it took me to like the second episode to realize that Cash Doll was in the show, like, because, you know, I was looking at her character and I was like, she looked familiar. I said, oh my god, this Cash Doll, like, she's a very great actress. Like, I would have never, you know, been able to, like, say to myself, like, oh, that's the rapper Cash Doll. But yeah, so the beginning the beginning of the freaking of episode one, when Meech comes home or whatever, he comes to the block and they have a party outside for him or whatever, I was like, that was strange, that was odd, I don't know, I was like, this shit is corny when I seen it. That was my initial reaction. I was like, this is corny, dog. But yeah, so the movie flashes back and we start to see him and Terry, their childhood together, growing up in the hood, and how they became, you know, the drug kingpins that they were. And to me, the story was kind of like going a little slow. It was nothing that really grabbed me, that made me be like, all right, I need to keep watching this show. The only reason why I was watching it was because, you know, it was about BMF. But I've seen like 10 million gangster shows and movies. Like, I watched Trap Queens, I watched American Gangster movies. I mean, this is nothing new to me, so I'm just like, you know what I'm saying? Like, it ain't nothing really gangster to me. The only exciting thing was saying when Terry got shot or whatever. I was like, oh wow, now I'm ready to see episode two. But other than that, I was just like, and then once I saw episode two, it wasn't really nothing exciting for me either. I guess, you know, maybe to some people, they would have been fascinated to know that they had a female in the crew, you know, during the early days. But I was not. It's really intriguing to me. But, you know, it's like they get the same actors that play in all the hood movies and all the hood shows. I mean, I guess they're kind of like typecast. So you see them in these roles now, you just like, okay. And now they got a psychopath on the show, and it kind of reminds you of The Wire a little bit, how they had somebody on there that wasn't wrapped too tight, you know, the dark skinned guy that's, you know, he plays by his own rules and he's feared in the streets and stuff like that. That's what it's looking like to me. That's my initial thoughts on the series. We're going to finish it out. You know, me and my husband was talking about it because I told him after we finished the second episode, I said, you know, the show kind of boring to me. I ain't really like too much feeling it like that. Like, all of the actors, they're doing a great job and everything. But like, I've seen this story like a million times before. It ain't nothing new to me. Like, you see the crooked cop, them paying off the cops and all this other stuff. Like, it ain't nothing to really reel me in, you know. And like I said, it's a lot of the same actors that are typecast. They've been in similar roles in the past, you know what I'm saying? But like I said, I saw Cash Doll, didn't even recognize her, because it's like she immersed herself into the role, which is great. Lil Zane is in the show too. I didn't recognize him at first, and then I was like, oh, this Lil Zane with a wig on. He ain't had much of a role, but maybe later on in the show he will. Lala's being Lala. I think she got some special connections to keep ending up in all these shows and everything, because she not the best actress. But she like, honey, I'm gonna get out here, I'm gonna do what it do, and I'm gonna use this sex appeal and let Carmelo see what he losing out on. That's how I feel. You know, she gonna probably be having a lot of sex scenes and stuff, so I'm pretty sure we got something to look forward to with that. But yeah, so we gonna finish it out though. We talked about it when we said we gonna finish it out. Then after that, we gonna move on to Power Book 2. Because we did watch Power Book 1, and we bought the DVD set for that, and that was good. That was a lot better than I was expecting it to be. But yeah, so my husband just came back with my cocktail, and we're gonna decide what we're gonna watch tonight. So yeah, I hope that you all enjoyed this video. If so, don't forget to hit that thumbs up button and subscribe to the channel if you haven't already, and hit that notification bell so that you'll be notified every time I make an upload. Hey, if you've seen If you've seen the BMF series on Starz, y'all drop down in the comment section and let me know, is it gonna get better? And let me know also if y'all checked out Grand View on NBC, because it didn't really get much promotion at all. I just so happened to see like an ad on Instagram or something. You know how Instagram be putting random stuff on your Instagram feed and you like, what the hell is this? I didn't sign up for this. I don't follow this account. What the fuck? You know what I'm saying? I seen something. I was like, the hell? And then I saw it was the Garrett Morris talking. So I said, let me unmute it. And then I was like, oh, okay. You know, of course I'm gonna watch anything. He promoting the first black regular SNL actor comedian on there, you know, of course. So yeah, I definitely didn't regret it. Yeah, so let me know if y'all happen to check that out. If so, let me know. And I'll also try to, if I can like find a link to the trailer or something, I'll put that in my description box, because I really think that y'all should like really give it a shot. And I'm so tired of networks canceling good shows that actually like have substance and, you know, are just good. Because it's like, you know, our other counterparts, they have like 10 million shows, you know. It's the same show repackaged and everything, and we, you know, only get bits and pieces and we never really have a shot. And I really want this show to like have a shot, you know what I'm saying? But anyway, I'm rambling, so I'm gonna go and I'm gonna see y'all in the next Vlogmas video. Bye.